And now for today's Bible question. Today we have been learning about what it will be like when Jesus returns to judge the world in righteousness, and how he will separate his true followers from those who were false Christians. We also heard how some will be judged in the fires of hell with the devil and his angels. Someone might ask the question, why would a loving God send anyone to hell? God never sends anyone to hell, but he does desire that everyone repent and accept his free offer of salvation through Jesus Christ. God wants all people to live in heaven with him, and that is why he sent his Son, Jesus, to die for our sins. We read in this passage today about the place called hell, a place of fire and torment, where it is described as outer darkness, and where there is weeping and gnashing of teeth. We have been warned about this terrible place so that we will avoid going there. It is of God's mercy that we are warned, and if we are wise, we will do what God requires to avoid this terrible and eternal judgment. There was an important phrase that we should take notice of in this passage. It was this, that the place of fire and torment was created for the devil and his angels. What this teaches us is that God never created the sufferings of hell for people like you and me, but rather for the fallen angels and for Lucifer the devil, who is also a fallen angel. These fallen spirits lived in the splendor of God's presence and had every joy and blessing. But still pride rose up in Satan's heart, and he wanted to be like God. Therefore God cast him out of heaven, and someday will cast him into the eternal fires of his judgment, where he shall never escape. God created hell for the devil and those evil spirits who followed him in rebellion against God. If men choose the same path of rebellion, then God is left with no other choice than to give them the same judgment. But that is not what God intended or desires. He has gone to the greatest length to save our souls. We notice in the teachings about separating the sheep and the goats that the Lord said to the sheep on his right hand that they should come and inherit the kingdom that was prepared from the foundation of the world. God has not only prepared a place of judgment, but he has also prepared a kingdom to inherit. These places of blessing and cursing were both prepared by God from the foundation of the world. God has set a course of judgment and a plan of reward in motion from the beginning. God, in his wisdom and foreknowledge, knew that some men would respond to his grace and mercy and would believe and submit to Jesus as their Savior, and some would choose their own path of rebellion, just like the devil chose. He therefore has prepared both places of destiny, but never intended for men to go into hell. If men end up in hell, it certainly is not God's fault. God has called all men to salvation, but he will not force men to come to heaven if they prefer to rebel against him. Hell is a horrible place where there will be endless suffering, pain, crying, and darkness. I plead with you to make sure you are prepared and ready to go to heaven, so you never have to enter into that place of eternal sorrow. Heaven is God's desire for you, and today he opens his arms wide to you and invites you to enter into his kingdom. All he asks of you is to come to Jesus in faith. Ask Jesus to forgive your sins and to be the Lord over your life. If you ask in sincere faith, then God will save you. In time, you should see changes in your life and spiritual fruit, which shows that the Holy Spirit lives inside of you. Do not be like so many church-going people who say they are Christians, but do not produce any spiritual fruit in their lives. Then the King will say to those on his right hand, come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Matthew chapter 25, verse 34.